Today we are making this Mac Aloo Tikki Burger. Of course, we are doing it in the McDonald's style. Hey foodies, welcome to Cooking Shooking. The process for making the Aloo Tikki is quite different, so watch it carefully. And you can see how crunchy it comes out, so let's begin cooking. First, here I have the peas or mutter, 1/4 cup guys, add it to a bowl. These are frozen, so I am adding them in some water and will let it soak for a couple of minutes. And to make the tikki thin, we need strength. For that, here I have got 1/4 cup of poha or rice flakes. Add them to a strainer and clean it really well with water. After cleaning or washing it, we'll just let it sit and drain for about 5 minutes. This poha will later soak up all the excess moisture in the aloo and it will make our tikki strong. Now for making the masala, here I've got a mixer jar. In this, we will take 2 tablespoons of dhania or fresh coriander leaves, about 7 to 8 mint leaves. These are homegrown, so they have a lot of flavor. You can also add more if you're using the market ones. Next, I'm taking 1/2 teaspoon of yellow chili powder, 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala, 1/4 teaspoon of black salt or kala namak, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper powder, 1 teaspoon of coriander powder. Here I'm taking 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1/2 teaspoon of chaat masala, 1/4 teaspoon of jeera powder, and about 8 to 9 cloves of garlic. These are small ones, guys. And finally, we are going to take a good teaspoon of lemon juice. These are all the masalas that we are using. Just add some water and make a paste. Make sure the coriander and mint is really well ground. Now, before we begin the cooking, let's prepare the potato as well. Here I've got 6 small boiled potatoes. Ideally, 4 to 5 are good. I'll share the exact quantity that you need to use for making 6 burgers. For now, just peel them like this and grate the potato with a thick setting. These are boiled and chilled, guys, for about 5 hours. Also ensure they are not overboiled. If you are using specific qualities of potato like Indori, Agra or Kufri ones, those are better. Basically, the ones we use for making chips are better for this recipe. I'm also using the normal variety. We can't make chips out of these potatoes. They don't turn out crispy, guys. Anyways, just take care of the overboiling. Here the potatoes are grated. For making 6 burgers, we basically need 1 3/4 cup of boiled grated potatoes. I've tried this recipe many times and this quantity is perfect for making 6 burgers. Normally, it's about 4 to 5 medium sized potatoes. Now let's quickly heat a kadhai. Let's make the masala for the burger. Here I'm taking 1 1/2 tablespoon of oil. Let it heat up, then we'll add the masala paste that we made earlier. And we have to cook this for about 30 seconds. And then we'll add the peas or mutter. Don't add the water, just add the peas, guys. And now all we have to do is cook them until the peas are soft and mushy. This step will take about 5 minutes. To cook them fast, add some salt into it, give it a stir and cook it with the lid on. In like 4 or 5 minutes, the excess moisture will also dry up. We don't want this to be wet and moist, guys. It needs to dry up. Here you can see peas are now starting to soften. We can mash it a little. This is the perfect time to add the poha that we soaked earlier. Make sure the poha is also dry. It shouldn't be wet and moist. Otherwise, no point adding it. Add the poha and now you have to cook it until you can't recognize it. As you cook it, it will automatically mash up, guys, and we won't be able to recognize it. In just a couple of minutes here, you can see we can't find the poha now. It looks dry and fluffy. About the peas, as we are making tikkis which are going to be thin, we can't have whole peas like this. So get your masher and start to mash them a little. Don't mash it completely, just try to press them once. We can't have whole peas popping out, right? So here you can see the texture looks good. Just a final stir and now our masala is ready. We won't add potatoes into it. In fact, we will turn off the heat and add this masala to the bowl of potatoes. That's right. Add the hot masala to the cold potatoes and then start mixing it. It will take a minute and you'll have this. Looks perfect, isn't it? We can recognize the peas as well as the potato shreds, just like the restaurant. Now keep this in the fridge for about 10 to 15 minutes so that the flavors can mingle up and they can develop as well. In that time, we will slice some onions. So just slice one onion and add it to a bowl. Over top of the onions, we will add a few ice cubes and top the bowl with some water. After adding the water, we will add about 1 tablespoon of vinegar. We just want the water to be cold and a little acidic. After doing all this, keep it in the fridge for the same 10 to 15 minutes of your time. For the sauce in the burger, we will take 1/4 cup of mayonnaise and we'll add about 2 tablespoons of tomato ketchup, half a tablespoon of paprika powder. You can also use Kashmiri red chili powder. Here I've taken smoked paprika and mix it together. Simple and fantastic. To make it better, you can also add some herbs. Our sauce is done, guys. Now for making the tikki crispy, we are going to take 6 tablespoons of maida or plain flour in a bowl. This is going to be the exact quantity that you'll need for the batter. You won't have any leftovers of the batter. So along with this, I am taking 4 tablespoons of cornstarch. We'll add some salt and use water to make a batter. Make it lump free, just like this. So the batter needs to be medium thin. Now let's do it. For making the tikki, take the tikki mix and divide it into 6 equal portions. Make sure there aren't major cracks. We'll basically smoothen it a little and then flatten it. It will be best if you can do it on a surface like a chopping board, flatten it on the both sides, and then you have to roll the sides just like this. Rolling it makes it even, and now this tikki is done. We will dip it in the batter and flip it to coat both the sides. Just use one hand for this step, guys. Make sure it's the prominent one for doing the batter stuff. Let the excess batter drip off and then we will drop it into the bowl of crumbs. Add some crumbs over top of the tikki. Guys, do use a large bowl like this with a lot of bread crumbs. This will make your life easy. You can just shake it like this and all the sides of the tikki will be coated. After shaking it, let it stay idle in the bowl itself for at least a minute. This will make sure. Similarly, we will repeat with all the tikkis, guys. It's better to shape all the tikkis at once and then we can do the crumbing and battering. For the breadcrumbs, guys, try to use panko breadcrumbs for the best results, but don't use the 4mm variety, that's too small. Here, this looks perfect. Let's take it out and place it in a plate. Don't want to eat all of them today. You can also freeze this tikki for up to 3 months in an airtight container. For cooking them, heat some oil and then add them to the hot oil. Make sure the oil is really hot. And for the best result, try to deep fry, otherwise they tend to become oily. You have to fry it on medium to high heat, and frying them till golden color should take you about 3 to 4 minutes. After they are golden from all the sides, you can flip it every now and then. Just take it out and place it in a perforated plate. Perforated plate or a pizza screen or a plate with holes will ensure steam can pass from all the sides and your tikki will not get soggy. When we use tissues or kitchen towel, they tend to get soggy very quickly, guys. In this method, they will remain crunchy for at least 30 minutes. Fantastic, isn't it? Our aloo tikki is done. Now let's be quick. This will remain crispy for 30 minutes, but who wants to eat it cold? Here I've got my homemade burger buns. That's right, I've made it at home. We will slice it into 2 portions and then toast it on a tawa on medium heat with some butter. So just add some butter in your tawa, place your buns and toast it until golden. I've tried to make the burger bun in the exact size and this is looking perfect, isn't it? Fun fact, these burger buns are lighter than the tikki that we made. That's right, the wet dough for the bun was 60 grams and the uncoated tikkis, I mean the tikkis without the batter and the breadcrumbs, were 70 grams. Isn't that interesting? Now these burger buns are golden, so let's take them out and place it in a plate for assembling. Oh wow, this looks fantastic, isn't it? Now we have to top the top part of the bun with our sauce. Just take about a tablespoon and place it on the top part. I'm adding some extra for the photo. You can spread it a little, just like this, and now we have to add the onion slices. Strain the onions, don't add the water along with it, and then over top of this you can add tomatoes if you want to. These days we don't get it, so I'm not adding it. And onions are our moisture barrier, they will keep our tikki crispy. So let's keep the tikki over it. And then comes our bottom bun on the top. Our burger is assembled, guys. Trust me, this will take time to make, but you can pre-prepare the tikki and keep it in your freezer once you try it. This simple burger will make you a fan of itself. Serve it plain or with some fries and enjoy your day. So when are you planning to make it? So how was the recipe, guys? If you enjoyed it, give it a like and share it with your friends. If you did not like it, click the dislike button. I hope to see you soon with more such yummy recipes. By the way, which other fast food kind of recipe would you like to see? Do comment. That's all for today. Bye. Take care. Happy cooking.